Hello everyone and welcome to the champion stage. Today we got Team Pointers in purple, Knockout in brown, and I'm joined alongside Jack, Isam, and Winky. How are you doing, Isam?
Doing great, Steno. What about you?
Yeah, good. Welcome to the final stage of the champion stage. Jack, what do you think about this game we got today?
Yeah, definitely going to be a close one. Obviously, Team Pointers only lost one game against Red Notice. But anyways, we're a bit late, so I'm going to introduce the team. I mean, Team Pointers only lost one game against Red Notice, but I'm going to introduce Team Pointers on the red side. So we've got Semgram, Mr. Vanker, Immortal Hero, Lanimal, and Hot.
Yeah, and on the other side, we have Team Knockout. We have Bit, Pagslow, New, Oxid, and Heaven on the blue side of the map.
Yeah, so today we got a good game going on, two really good teams. Obviously, we're starting our first round in Sandbox, and then we'll move over to Cross, and then finally Sandal. So it'll be six rounds for today, and yeah, hopefully we enjoy it.
Yeah, exactly. We can already see actually the first major pull. Obviously, we had a technical issue in the beginning, but we're seeing Immortal managing to pull that first flag capture 14 pointers, which is quite shocking because obviously it's a bit late into the round, nearly 4 minutes into the game until the first capture. But obviously, we can see the competitiveness come out in both these teams already. Obviously, like you said, Steno, amazing introduction into the champion stage. And you did ask how I thought this map was going to go, but what about you?
Honestly, I feel like the heavy favorites for this game is Team Pointers. They've been doing well so far, but I wouldn't underestimate Knockout. They're a very good team. They work well together, and they've beaten some really good teams as well. They've been in two teams already that are in the champion stage. They've won against Black Mirror, and they've won against ATB. So far, Team Pointers had a really good push. They were able to pull two flags, but let's see what Knockout can do. 5 minutes and 40 seconds left. We'll see what they can do with the overdrives.
What about you, Sam? What's your thoughts about this game we've got today? Obviously, like Steno said as well, we're going to be seeing Sandbox, Sandal, and then Cross. But what's your thoughts?
Well, my thoughts are actually that Team Pointers are going to be doing what they do all the time. Just pressure the enemy team, as we can see right now. It's already 2-0 in the first 5 minutes of the game. And we can see that actually Knockout are trying to, push back and the defense side. Also, you can see that they're not winning with a lot, like with not that amount of flags. It's basically right now 2-1, and the first flag for Team Knockout just got capped. For me, I actually... I was expecting that a Knockout would just get dominated. I'm not gonna lie, but it seems like they are actually doing the otherwise, and they're proving me wrong here. I see them on their defense, and they're doing really well on it at the moment. Still, also, I think that Team Pointers are doing that pressure that I spoke about.
Go ahead.
I would say every team that's made it to this stage. I wouldn't underestimate them. I feel like everyone, if they work together, they have a good push. Right now, Team Pointers have a really good push. Hot uses OD. Immortal has his Viking OD as well. Can he reach Heaven? Bit is there to take him out. Lenyamal? This is highly contested. Yeah. They weren't letting them cap that one easily.
By the way, I want to note something because it's really important. For this stage that we're going to be in, it's going to be a single elimination. If one team loses the match, they're just going to get out of the tournament and they will just end up at one of the top eight places in this tournament right now. There's no other matches. There will not be any more matches after only one match. So basically, it's if you win or it's your if you lose.
Yeah,
winner
go home. That's exactly. I mean, they're already playing from their home, so they're not going to be moving much. But what I was going to say as well, both of these teams, like you said, I wouldn't underestimate any team. I can imagine all teams now have been training so, so hard to beat this. Because obviously, like you said, it's the single elimination factor we're in right now, where all these teams are going to be seeing a game each day. We're not going to be seeing two games every day. And they're going to be playing to stay within the game and get those paints, get the big reward at the end, the pot of gold, as we can say. But also a load of achievements within the game as well. But anyways, we're going to be seeing another pull from Immortal here, and it's looking like a capture within 2 minutes and 40 seconds left of this match. It's looking like Team Pointers are dominating this round, but I wonder what's going to be happening in the second round. I mean, I don't want to speak too soon, but I don't know if Knockout can come back from this.
Yes, for one or two at the moment. By the way, I don't know if you guys noticed, but it seems like both of the teams are playing with their paints. Like the team Knockout are playing with their brown paint, and the team Pointers are playing with the purple paint. I'm really not satisfied a little bit with how like the paints, like the thingy about that the paints doesn't have the logo, but still it works to have the paint as your name, you know.
Yeah, I think it's a good honor. I think there is some valid reason behind that, but I think the paints are really cool, and I love when it gets to the further stage, each team's wearing their paints. You know, it's the playoffs and it's getting intense. And yeah, it's good to see.
And I think go ahead.
Talking about paints, I mean, obviously, I'm sure everyone's got their preference on team wise, but what's your preference on the colors? I mean, I don't know. I feel like some of these paints don't actually match the color of the team logos, regardless of not having the team logo on the paints. I'm sure, like Stono said, there's a reasoning behind that. But I would have thought they'd be within the same color, you know. But I mean, they're still cool. It's quite nice to have your own paint as a team. And it's an achievement, right?
Yeah, for sure. Having your name on a paint solidifies yourself and your team. I think so far my favorite has been the purple of Team Pointers, and then maybe a Red Notice's pink.
Yeah, I like, I think it's Diamond's one, the slight cyan, I believe.
Oh yeah, they have
a nice Toxic one. I mean, Toxic and Diamonds have a nice one. Yeah. But
I think Diamonds have yeah, never mind. Either Scion or something else. But a blue.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But
also
30 seconds left.
Yeah, 30 seconds. I was just gonna say the same. It's 30 seconds left. 5-1 for Team Pointers right now. It looks like they're having the match for this side, and I see that Immortal using the overdrive, but still, is I think it's gonna be the Thixis cap here. 6-1 for Team Pointers at 10 seconds left on the clock. It's gonna finish like that, I think.
Yeah, Team indeed. Pointers did choose this map, so I would say they have like their preference advantage, but I feel like Knockout, if they play well, they can still win this round, hopefully in the next round.
I hope to. We also can see if they can do other, we can predict other performance from them in the next maps that's going to be coming. Like I think I have seen Knockout play well in Cross before.
I think the next map is Sandal, right?
Yeah, it's Sandal. I hope that they reach Cross. That's the thing.
Yeah, that definitely be a good game. If they manage to reach the whole amount of rounds, right? Be a bit more competitive. But obviously it is currently 1-0 to Team P. The veterans within the esports scene as of now, I think they're the longest holding team, I believe. I'm not sure if there's any other. Maybe Stano, you know better than me on that.
Nah, you're right. Team Pointers have been honestly dominating, or at least contending for every championship or tournament for the for the past few seasons. I feel like their main contender or opposition was Penguins, but we know that they're not playing anymore. I feel like now those guys have been replaced with a team like Bulls, which are like mostly Diamonds now, or
Revenge.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, regardless of Team Pointers, they, even if they've not won the previous majors or champions, they've always been like the runner-up. They've always been there in the top threes or whatnot. So they're definitely, it's definitely going to be a hard game for Knockout. But who actually took that Overdrive to start
it
off
was,
with?
It was Heaven.
Heaven. I mean, yeah. Immortal have the advantage here. Whether they're going to use it straight off the bat or hold on to it for a while, we'll have to see what their game plan is going to be on the second round of Sandbox. I was about to say Sandor. But Sandbox.
I mean, like, to be honest, for me, I think Kelly said this before. We had to choose some teams for this, like, you know, to actually encourage and to go for, because me and him were actually going for team I was going for Team Sincerity and he was going for Fichki, and both the teams got eliminated in the last stage. So he was like, okay, let's choose other teams. And the first thing came up on my mind was actually Team Pointers. And, you know, like, I went for that because there is one player that I really like in that team. And that player, as I said before, he gives me the, you know, the thoughts about the old tanky and the old esport. It's already known who he is. It's basically Immortal. He has been in the game and he has been in the esport for a long, long time. And his performance in all of the games basically is just incredible. Like, I can see that he saved a lot of flag captures before. He saved his team multiple times. He just knows when to go for the flag, when not to go, what to do. And as I said before, it's basically a game of decision making. If you have bad decision making, you can just lose the game.
Yeah, true. I mean, also teamwork at the same time. I think I'm lagging a bit, but Immortal is going to be picking up that flag. But this might not be the first capture. Bit is holding off an angle here with Shaft, also new behind him, and Osid, and that's going to be a nice return from them.
Yeah, it is returned.
Great play from them holding off that flag, that Aeris overdrive, and then Bit holding off, getting time for his teammates to come and return that.
That's kind of where that decision making comes into play, whether they should be more aggressive or hold off and just make sure their team is capable of returning it, and just being aware of where everyone is at the right time, right? But we'll have to see if Team Pointers can pull this off again. It looks like Hot and also Immortal are pushing up on that right side, whilst we have Lenormand and Semgran and also Mr. Banker on the left side there, closing it in here whilst Knockout are all within their base. And looking like Immortal is going to be picking up this flag.
Yeah, look at Immortal, man. He just landed three shots on two members from Knockout. Like, he just landed those shots, and he calculated the distance that he would need to shoot from. And he calculated that both of them should be standing beside each other, so he can actually secure a double kill and just take that flag and make it a first cap for this game.
Sid uses his overdrive, but it looks like Immortal is going to be picking up this OD box, and he might actually be able to capture another flag here. Takes that flag, Lenormand going to be landing some hits here on Heaven, forcing him to use his repair kit here. He doesn't use his DA, he goes straight for a speed, and this is going to be the second capture for Team Pointers.
Okay, so I think right now it's basically Niu going for the flag and Oxid on his right side. He's trying to cover him, but there's a lot of damage from Pointers. Mr. Vanka is actually using the strong combo, the Aeris Thunder, and he's just standing on the left of the map. It's the first time I see that the Aeris Thunder stands on the left and right side of the sandbox. It's basically I'm used to the Shaft being there all of the time to cover the sides of the map and cover the platform, so from any potential pose of the flag. But suddenly I see that Vanka is staying on the left side of the map. Basically, I have noticed that also none of the teams are basically using anything, that's not being used frequently. Like right now, the only thing that I haven't seen before, I mean, like, I have seen, but not really much, was the Aeris Thunder. All of the other combos were being used before, and we are, we already know them.
Yeah, true. I mean, I know Steno and I, we've played a couple of these sport modes, And we've been using this, I mean, I've been using this combo within private trainings, and it's really OP, whether you know how to use it or not. It's not actually that hard, and it is quite a useful hole and turret to be using on the left and right along with the shaft, because obviously it's a heavy hole. You don't really see heavy holes, like you said, but Mr. Banker brought it into the game. Like in the previous season, we saw him use shaft. Which season was it? Season 3, I think. He was using Mammoth Shaft or something on bridges. But Mammoth. Yeah.
Mammoth Shaft. Oh my God.
I think so. Was it Stunner?
Well, yeah, you're right.
I'm mistaken, for a different season. But it was something crazy we've never seen before. But we're seeing a lot of these teams now rock out this Aeris Thunder, because that overdrive's overpowered. And also Thunder does splash damage along with a load of damage. If you land hits on it, it's basically the same as Gauss or those two turrets.
Yeah, and I think Mr. Vank over there playing with Aeris Thunder is the one who brought in that strategy.
Exactly. We're seeing Pac Julo trying to mimic him. But I don't think he can live up to Mr. Vank's standards. But we'll have to see. I mean, right now, both of them are doing a tremendous job. But obviously, Team Pointers, the Undefeated, are looking like they're winning this game as well. It's looking like Lenormand is going to be using his overdrive. So is Hot. But, ooh, Bit misses his overdrive on Hot there. He angled it into the ground. But Ossid is going to be
picking up that overdrive. Did you see that shot by Samgrand? He just took out Oxid when he overdrived with his paladin. I see a push from Team Pointers right now. Hot going for the flag. Oxid is trying to actually block him, but Lenimal takes the flag here, and he's damaging himself with his own rockets by shooting Pugslow in front of him. But still, his teammates are covering him. Immortal on his back, trying to defend him from any possible threats, and it's gonna be the fourth cap for Zero for Team Pointers at the match right now. Just incredible, man.
Yeah, Team Pointers, a lot of times when they're pushing, they're pushed throughout the whole map. There's one left, one middle, one right, and Knockout's always on respawn. While when Knockout's pushing up, there's a lot of Team Pointers players in their base or surrounding them. We see a good push from them right now. Ossid has his critical on Vulcan. It's just Lenormand and Immortal's taken out. This could be the first capture for them. Ossid's going to go all the way. Team Pointer still on respawn. Pac-Jo has his Aeris overdrive. He's going to use it here.
I think that overdrive by Pac-Jo actually ruined a little bit on Team Pointers. I think the flag is going to be pulled again. And Samgrand takes out the flag holder, and I think a little bit silver lag. Yes. Right now, I think that Team Pointers regained the control. They're out of the base. Lenimal on the right side, and they're damaging Bit a lot. Immortal takes him out. And there's an overdrive dropping. We see Lenimal going for it. He uses his repair kit. I don't think he can.
He managed. Yeah, he did.
Yeah, on the last second.
We saw Immortal use his overdrive just in case, but it's going to be a little bit of a waste from him. He did manage to kill Ossid there, though. But I mean, 2 minutes and 16 seconds left within this last round. On Sandal, we have to see what happens here. We saw, like you guys said, a really nice push and flag capture from Knockout there when they pushed the left side. But I'm not too sure if they have the time to do that same kind of strategy. It worked out extremely well from them, and it's looking like Lenormand and Hot are going to be doing that same. Oh my God.
It's the excitement.
Losing my English there. Same strategy, and they're managing to pull that flag, and it's looking like it might be a capture. Ooh, there's only Immortal left. Lenormand trying to land some shots on us from behind, but Immortal.
He actually managed to cap it. It's 5-1 right now.
Yeah, I don't know what happened to me. I think it was the excitement and the heat blowing me out of breath. But anyways, we live and learn. But
It's really hot here as the match is going. You see the match is going and it's hot, and it's hot in real life, man. This is getting ridiculous. 38 degrees Celsius at the morning and 30 at night.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's always hot when Stano's it as well.
Oh, yeah. But like, it's kind of crazy how in the legend stage we're seeing pointers dominate a team like this. Like, I think Naka got one flag in the previous round, one flag again in this round. I think almost the same score. So you can see that team pointers are pretty dangerous in sandbox. I know for future teams.
You mean in the champion stage? We've passed the legend stage.
Oh yeah.
It's weird, isn't it? Because so many stages, but I mean, it's interesting. I want to see what everyone's thoughts on this new format is, because obviously we like to see what everyone else thinks about this new format. It's definitely a different one, but it's looking like definitely team pointers have gotten a grip on it. Like we can clearly see, and like you just stated, they are dominating. So I'm looking forward to seeing what they're going to be able to do in the next maps. Obviously, the next map we have is Knockout's Choice. So we'll have to see if they can come back on it. I believe, what map was it?
It is going to be the Sandal, actually. Yeah. Second map.
Indeed. So we'll see. But what's your predictions? Stano, you want to go first?
What map was it?
Sandal.
Yep.
Yeah.
Honestly, so far from this sandbox game, I can see that team pointers have been really good at controlling the map. They have really good map presence. Knockout tries to push one side with a lot of people, but they just end up getting surrounded. In Sandal, I feel like it would be the same situation, but Knockout has chosen Sandal, so let's see what their strategy is there. I feel like they can put up at least a better fight than they did in Sandbox.
Yeah, and what about you, Sam?
Well, for me, I think that Sandal is going to be, more of a game to take and get. Like, basically, for both teams, right now in Sandbox, it's a really small map, where I have said this a million times, actually. That Sandbox is really small, and it just consists of a platform and a square thingy around it. Like a square passage, so it's really quick. You can capture like five flags really quick. And Sandal, you have to go. The only way to do that is basically through the middle. And through the middle, there are a lot of dangers. You can get shot by a shaft shot, thunder, Gauss, anything in the mid, basically. But the thing is that it has two advantages, actually. The first advantage is the two ramps on the left and right side. It can give you a little bit of a cover if the enemy is in their base. And the second advantage is basically the walls and obstacles and the houses in the map. So I would say that Sandal is way better than Sandbox, because Sandbox is kind of really an open map, not like Sandal, not like Cross. Both of those maps have some obstacles and walls, and whenever you have obstacles and walls, it's basically better. So it gives you more sustain in the game. It gives you more cover to take. So you can actually, when you get shot, you can shoot back at the enemy. So yeah, that's what I think. And I think maybe Knockout can do something in Sandal.
Yeah, I got to agree with what you said about the shafts. I mean, there's more potentials for them. They got the platform behind the flag, their flags, and also they got the left and right. When Sandbox, it was more they either had the left and right, they had control, and they always had to be aware because people would be pushing them. There'd be a hard focus, so they couldn't destroy pushes, right? But I'm looking forward to Sandal. I'm not a big fan of the map Sandal. I don't know why. I just have this, not a hatred for it, but I wouldn't pick it myself. But I'm looking forward to seeing both these teams clash into either winning or losing, right? So we're going to be seeing them reset and get into this third round. And it's currently 2-0 for team pointers.
But by the way, before we start, like, basically, I wanted to ask a question for both of you and to myself, and I would answer it at last. What do you guys think? Yeah, what do you guys think about the maps? Which map do you think is played the most? And can you just tell me, like, the first three maps, like, the top three maps that has been played in this tournament? So we tell our viewers that, how much maps that were actually being played in the top three, most top three frequently played matches, basically.
Would you like me to go first, Anna, or?
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
Well, I mean, in my from what I've seen, and I think it depends really on the team. Obviously, we've seen some teams pick like Highland and Red Alert and also Molotov, but we don't really see those as such. I would say the biggest maps which have been picked, I'm going to say four because I can't really say three, but definitely Sandbox, definitely Sandor or Iran, and then the fourth one would be Cross. And then the outside maps would be more Red Alert, Molotov, and Highland. But we've seen those more in the Legend stages. I feel like in the Champion stages, we're going to see more maps which are equalized. So maps which like are Sandbox, Cross, and Sandal, because on these other maps like Molotov, Red Alert, and Highland, they've got a disadvantage on one of the sides, right? But that's my thoughts. But what about you, Stena?
So we got seven esports maps. Mm-hmm. I feel like my preference for watching and commentating the maps I like are Iran. I really enjoy watching Iran. Yeah. Something we haven't seen in a while is Red Alert. I think Red Alert's also a pretty fun map to watch, pretty dynamic. And I would say Sandbox, just because Sandbox has been pretty competitive, pretty dynamic. But I also have enjoyed the Highland maps that we've witnessed recently.
Well, if you ask me, as I said, for the last opinion, I would actually say that I think that in order, the maps that have been played the most is Sandbox at the first place, and I think Iran the second. Maybe I'm really confused between Sandal and Cross, but basically I would go for Sandal for the third, Highland for the fourth, and Cross for the fourth, Highland for the fifth, and Molotov, and then lastly Red Alert. But no, Red Alert and then Molotov, because I really want to see Molotov and Red Alert being played more, because in Molotov it's basically really hard to capture flags. It's really hard and it's really easy at the same time. In Molotov, if you manage to make someone basically fall into one of the holes in the middle of the map,
we've seen that a lot as well.
Yeah, we have seen it a lot, and it looks funny and it looks really cool at the same time, because just one player can just shoot with a striker shot and it can fall, you know. So
yeah, exactly.
Basically, it's just amazing to see that map. I really enjoy seeing it. And for Red Alert, I just like to see Red Alert because I really miss the old days. That's why I really like Red Alert.
Yeah, I think Red Alert was one of the most popular maps back then, right?
Yeah.
By the way, guys, we are looking like we got some issues as of now, but we will be back in the game shortly, unfortunately. Had to happen on the first day of the champion stage. But I think I'm back in. I'm not sure about you guys.
I'm still checking, yep.
But anyways, I do believe going back to the map Sandal, I feel like we might see some combination changes, maybe Aero Shaft come into play, because I think that's quite a useful combination within this map. And Stena, are you able to join back or?
Yeah, I think we're good to go now. The players are joining back, the spectators are joining back, and I think we're going to be starting shortly. Apologies for that delay.
I think everyone is here now, I think. Yeah, we're clear to start. Yep. It's just a little lag issue, but it's going to be fine. I see Hot has his Rico Paladin. Rico Paladin, have we seen that, guys?
Yeah. I think we've seen it on this map a couple of times. I don't want to say the teams because I can't remember off the back of my head, but I believe we've seen it a couple of times in this map.
Yep. What about the striker hunter?
We've seen it before as well. I've seen it on Iran come into play. But I remember a lot of teams using Volk and Dictator on this map, but I'm not too sure why both these teams aren't playing with it. I'm not sure about Knockout. Obviously, all their players aren't in the map as of now, but when they do reset, we'll see what the final combinations are. But I'm not sure.
You said Volk and Dictator?
Volk. Yeah, I did say Volk. That, didn't I?
I don't think I've seen that one. I don't know.
Nah, I meant to say Vulcan Striker. No, what? Vulcan Striker. Yeah.
Okay.
You understood what I mean.
Striker Dictator, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got lost a little bit.
But in Sandal, I have seen them switch over that Striker to Hunter a lot, or even just chalk it up completely and take Thunder.
I don't know. I feel like if you can land the hits, it's quite OP.
Oh,
but,
sure.
Yeah, you're definitely right. I mean, maybe Thunder would be a safer option, but I feel like the reason why they've not gotten Thunder is possibly because they're putting Shaft on Crusader, and maybe they're using the Thunder Aris again. I'm not sure if Mr. Banker will be using that. Is there server lag again, or is it me?
No, it's not server lag. I think there is some players who still has issues with connection in the game. That's why they're actually joining the map, but still some players are having issues.
Oh, rip.
Yeah. Okay.
I think they're resetting, maybe. Hopefully. We shall see. But anyways. Yeah. Third map on the go. We shall see very shortly what is the outcome. Obviously, anyone new to watching the stream or any newcomers to the stream, obviously Team Pointers managed to win those two rounds on Sandbox from the score you can see on the stream. That is currently 2-0 for Team Pointers.
Yep. You've seen the pressure that Team Pointers did on the second match than the first match. I saw that actually Knockout was pushing back in the first match, but it seemed like in second match, I don't know, I saw Bit leaving at last minute in the game.
Yeah, I feel like Knockout is a good team. They've definitely earned their spot in this stage, but having their first round against Team Pointers, who are favored, I'd say, to win this whole tournament, it's going to be a challenge for them. And Team Pointers, if they do advance, they'll have to go against either Red Notice or Dreamers, which I think would be a really good match. Those guys play tomorrow.
Yeah, Red Notice against Dreamers is going to be an interesting one. Fortunately, yep. I won't be here for that one, but I wish I was, honestly. And I'm not saying that Team Pointers and Knockout isn't great, but I do feel like Red Notice against the Dreamers is a bit more of a competitive level we're going to be seeing, especially when we get into the semifinals and finals. That's going to be next level gameplay and just overall fun, I feel like. But do you have any predictions, actually, on what team's going to win come second, third place?
Or like the end of the tournament or now?
The end.
Well, let's deal with the left side of the bracket first. I think Team Pointers right now, they have been playing pretty well. I feel like they'll go through, and Red Notice, I think they'll go through as well. They've 3-0 Dreamers in the past in the Challenger stage. Even though Dreamers have a good team, I feel like they have gotten a lot better, so it might be a bit more competitive. But I think that semifinals before the finals is going to be Pointers against Red Notice. And for the right side of the bracket, I feel like Toxic against Diamonds will have to be the semifinals.
Yeah, I can't agree more, honestly. You said it perfectly. But what about you, Sam? Do you reckon that will be the outcome, or do you have a different prediction?
Well, to be honest, for me, I think that if we look from the left side of the bracket, we can see that for this match that we are in right now, I would say that Team Pointers would win this one. And then on the next match, I don't know. I predict that basically maybe what is his name? Maybe Dreamers can win this and pull it off against Team Pointers. And on the right side, I think that Toxic are going to be qualifying. And it's going to be really hard to basically say who is going to win from both the teams, like from Team Diamonds or Team Black Mirror. I don't know. But it seems like I would go for Diamonds, to be honest. And I would say, like, from after that, we might see Diamonds against Team Pointers in the finals, and I suspect that Team Pointers are gonna go first, Diamonds are gonna go second, and for lastly, the third place might go for Team Toxic.
Yeah, I don't know.
How would that work though? You said, oh, Diamonds against Toxic, that's what you said?
Yes, Diamonds okay. against Toxic.
So then it would be Toxic against Red Notice for that third place, huh?
I don't know. I said Dreamers would
He said Dreamers would win against Toxic, so it would be Toxic against Dreamers.
Yeah.
You're saying Dreamers will beat Red Notice?
I'm just guessing. I'm just guessing.
Oh, no, I was just trying to get what you're saying. I was just trying to visualize it.
I was just guessing.
That's a good prediction.
Are you guys in the new map, just to make sure?
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, cool. Hopefully, my broadcaster says as well. Wasn't Winky, you here, buddy?
Winky is here, I think, yes. I will speak on his behalf, you know? I cannot speak.
Yeah. If you get it wrong, then I'll blame you. But hopefully there's no issues now. We've got a new map link and we're in it. We're going to be seeing the third round being played on Sandal. I believe, will we be seeing new players come into play? Wait, hold on. The same players are playing for both teams. Maybe we can introduce both teams once again for any newcomers.
It's going to be the first time we do that, right?
No. We've done it before. First time for everything, right? So, yeah. Sam, if you'd like to go first.
Okay, I would go... to make it a change, I would just go for Team Pointers, and maybe any of you can go for Knockout, okay? So, I would say that on the blue side, we have Team Pointers. We have Mr. Vanka, Immortal Hero Doe, Lenimo, Samgran, and Hop.
No one to do rock, paper, scissors for this one?
I choose rock, and you will lose.
You lost. It's you. Go ahead, bro.
Okay, so as I said, we got Nako in the brown. I think it honestly looks pretty nice. We got Heaven, New, Bit. How are you guys saying this name? Pakjilo?
Pakjilo.
Pakjilo. And then lastly, we got Acid.
So I don't know. I've got to disagree with that paint, buddy.
Yeah,
I don't like it. I hate the color brown. I think that's why.
Yo, what?
Yeah, I don't know.
I think it's pretty clean. Kind of looks a little bit like veteran.
That is true. I think it would be dope if there's like a matte black color or something, you know?
Yeah, matte black, map. White.
Yeah.
Ooh. That would be interesting.
Yeah, it would. Especially for a team like Black Mirror. But anyways, into this round, Immortal Hero straight off the bat is going to be using his overdrive. Going to be picking up this flag. Got to watch out for Pakjilo there. Samgran takes him out, clears the area for him. It's looking like this first capture might already go to Team Pointers. I love how they all just go there like a bodyguard, surround that flag there. And that's going to be the first capture within 45 seconds of the third round.
Yeah, it seems like, as Seno said in this sandbox map, you see them actually spreading all over the map when there is like a plan to actually take the flag and just make a first capture. We have seen Lenimal. I think it was actually either Hot or Lenimal blocking Osid on the right side and blocking all of the damage from Immortal. And I saw that Immortal went from the middle, actually feeling so safe because his team was covering him, and he just took the short way and the easiest way, and he just went for the cap.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they make it look so easy, like spreading butter on toast or something, you know? But, yeah, we saw a couple overdrives being used there to pick up that OD box in the middle, and it was in favor of Knockout picking it up. I believe Osid picked it.
Yeah, very tight picking up that overdrive. Nice overdrive from Osid to get it. They have a pretty good push here, but Team Pointer is all in their base. I feel like they'll be able to fend this off pretty easily.
Yeah, there are three players. There are three players there, but Samgran gets taken out by Bit, and Vanka also was taken out before him. Immortal gets taken out in mid as well. Heaven is going to fall right there. Lenimal has his overdrive, but I don't think he's going to use it right now. Oh, okay. This looks like a push for Team Pointers. I see Hot on the left side with his overdrive, but I don't think he's going to use it. They decided to retreat because they saw that Niu was actually sneaking from the right side. And Hot is still there, actually. He's trying to take out a bit, but he's hiding in the corner. Vanka joining for support, but I think it was a little bit late. Oh, the overdrive by Lenimal. He actually disabled two players and took out one. But look at Bid, guys. Look at Bid. He's just doing great. Like, he took out two players right now. He took out two players in their base before they even do that attack.
It's been quite a useful shaft, especially in Sandbox as well. I noticed that he was playing pretty well with a shaft. I actually didn't pick it up back then, but is it me or is it server lag?
Yeah, it is server lag. I think it's gonna be the same like before. We might have to play the game again. Yes.
Oh, that's so unfortunate.
Yeah, this one's a long one.
Yeah, for real. Damn.
Anyway. Until the game, we get back into the game, and the spectator is back, let's speak about a really interesting topic. And I know everyone is here interested for it. What do you guys think about the Tanky Fund?
Then I'll let you go first, because I got everything in the game, bro.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, I see you, Jack. I see you. Okay. Anyway, well, to be honest, I see that it started off really, really slow at the start of the fund. And somehow... And when we reached Magnetic Pallets or Helios, I think, somehow the fund just flew in 4 days. Like, we hit Swarm, and then we are in the middle of the way to Pulsar, and there is still 6 days and 8 hours left. And to be honest, in my opinion, I think at the first, I thought that we'd be stopping at Legacy Hammer. But right now, it passed Vacuum Shell. That I actually made it as a plan B to say if we're going to be stopping at that. And now it's getting to Pulsar and still 6 days. I actually think that we are going to be seeing everyone with Armadillo now in the whole game.
Yeah, could you buy a bundle? I'm trying to get Tesla Pulsar, please.
have you not got the paint bundle?
No, I didn't. And I think Steno, what happened with you? Did you get it?
Oh, yeah, of course. I had to get it.
I was about to say, bro.
Someone is rich. Someone is rich. Okay, guys. Okay, I get that you guys are so rich. I am so poor.
Wait, you didn't get it?
No, I only could afford the... What is his name? The 900. Supplies? Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, no, man.
At least you're participating, man.
Yep. Yeah. I think that, the secret behind how the fund is growing right now is basically because that people are trying to get the new Scorpion turret. And they're trying also to get the new what is his name? The Salamander and the other one for Thunder. I don't really remember his name.
It was like Blunder or something.
It sounded like that.
I heard some reviews that it's not too good. I haven't had it myself.
I mean, I have
Hyperspeed.
The Hyperspeed.
I got it, and I can vouch it's amazing.
It is.
With Crisis, you can do 8k damage.
Oh, with Crisis. Open.
You need a couple of supplies, but I mean, it's got my vouch.
Like Luke Steno, I have joined a game, okay, and it was with Doshek. I think he's one of the helpers. And he was actually going like 80 kills and 10 deaths on a DM match or on a CTF. I think I was like, okay, come on, man, calm down a little bit. I need to get some kills. I need to finish missions, and he was just destroying tanks like left and right, and just it was really, really you know, like I couldn't understand how did he do that amount of damage with just an augment.
Yeah, it's crazy. It is kind of crazy. I'm sure it will get nerfed, but for now, obviously, when they introduce something, it's always pretty OP. It's like when they introduce Pulsar, that was pretty good. But yeah, by the way, guys, when we do manage to restart this round, it will be a current flag score of 1-0 for team pointers, as they did manage to capture that flag. But yeah, we'll be going into the game shortly, hopefully.
I think we got into the game and the game is lagging again.
Oh, wait. The game's...
Yeah, they got back into the game and it's not looking really well. They lagged again. Anyway, let's not make it boring for everyone until they actually get on with this issues. I think it's server issues, maybe. But still. I think we're just going to manage to play the game today, maybe. Let's just actually, you know, like answer the questions of people who are asking, like the viewers we have. If you guys have any questions, you can guys ask it in the chat, and we are gonna be doing our best to actually answer those questions.
Yeah. Here we go. Yeah, I like that again. This is great. Be a first game for the champion stage.
I know, right? On the behalf of the viewers, I have a question for you, Jack.
Mm-hmm.
What, like, in the next tournament, you know, do you think that you will make a team or join a team and play in the esports?
Excuse me, you're going to have to repeat that, sorry.
Like, are you going to make a team in the next upcoming tournament? Are you going to join one?
Depends. Stena, you want to join Wasteland?
Run it back?
Yeah, run it back. Wasteland? Let's go. No, probably not. I'm not going to lie. It was a bit of a failure. It depends, actually, if Winky wants to take me on into HYD.
I don't think Winky likes you anymore.
His writing in full caps, yes, even though I kicked him, but I mean,
I mean, you guys are gonna go to teams and just leave me alone. Okay, guys, okay, we're not friends anymore. Come on,
Sam, man, someone has to commentate. Come on,
I mean, yeah, but still, man, like, I would not be playing in the whole each round, you know, like,
we'll put you as a reserved player, then we got,
yeah, it. Yeah, basically,
you're just there for the paints, so we understand.
Come on. Okay.
I don't know. Maybe it depends. What about you?
I would join for supplies.
In parkour, you get supplies, but you lose a load as well from all the tricks. But
Yeah, I'm I like I spam supplies even in normal games. I spam supplies also. I'm basically in silence games and what is his name? Ryu games all of the time. So I basically just spam them out. So I drop down to a lot of you know, to like 1k each supply or something like that. So yeah, I be needing supplies a lot.
You only have 1k supplies.
I get down to that. And get like
you violated yourself right now.
Right. I said I'm actually down to 1k, but also it increases up to 5 and 6k each. So yeah, it's fine.
Okay. I mean, if you play esports, you do need supplies. It's upgrades you don't need. My bad. Yeah. I don't know what you're going to do about that, bro.
Isam, have you played this format before?
Yeah, okay. Jack, you know what happened, right?
I know. You played in with us, I think, once.
Yeah.
Okay. It wasn't that bad. What were you playing? Hunter Thunder, I think it was?
No, I was playing Paladin Vulcan because, you know, I'm a mouse player. So basically, I was assigned to it, I think, because I wanted to play with mouse.
I mean,
still, you were there. You were there, weren't you?
I was, but I was in the other team, I think.
Oh, no, man, you were in my team. It was an Iran game, I remember.
Honestly, I've played so many recently. I can't remember. I vaguely remember playing with you, but I can't remember the exact game. Did we lose or win?
Yeah, we lost really bad.
Yeah, well, don't bring it off in stream then.
Okay, man. Fine then. Let's keep secrets.
Exactly. Well, it's not a secret anymore, but yeah.
It's all trainings, man. It's fine when it's training. So it's yeah, basically exactly, yeah. It's basically not a tournament or something.
Exactly. But I mean, Steno, you played this season. How did you find it to be? What's your thoughts about this whole the way it's formatted and everything?
I think it's pretty cool. The format's kind of growing on me. It's a lot more dynamic, a lot of team strategy. Watching these playoff games and these champion games, the teams with their paints on, makes me miss the competitiveness and the intensity of some of these matches. It's honestly really fun. Even you can kind of tell from playing those like TKBs that we do for fun.
Yeah. I mean, it definitely is growing on me, obviously. I kind of joined last year, and I just started to get into it was light format, medium, no, TOF, and then setups. And then obviously it all changed to basically TOF, and then it changed to this. So it's been a bit of a rocky situation going up and down into different formats. But honestly, I quite like this format and the maps as well. It's easy to learn, basically, what I've noticed. And it is fun. But yeah, for sure. I'm looking forward to the next major. But I wonder when it's going to be as well. Like how large the gap difference is going to be and whatnot.
Well, to be honest, I really miss Master of the Sword. It was a really good tournament. I miss seeing the 1v1s of XBBP. But still, like, as we can see in the this format that we're having right now, it's pretty much dynamic, and it's pretty much you can use you can make plays with the overdrive. Yes, we had Master of the Sword. Yes, we had Domination Series, the TOF, and all of those tournaments. But still, I can say that this is one of the interesting formats that I have seen. Yeah, I want to see the other formats back. But still, I think that in the MM format, the esport format that we have right now, it's pretty much dynamic, pretty much strategic, and pretty much team communication based. Because we have seen a lot of overdrives that save the day in a lot of matches that have been going on in the past stages. So basically, yeah, like we have seen amazing plays by players also. And, you know, like, as I said, it's really satisfying seeing a player just taking out a whole team by himself just for his overdrive. I think we didn't see that before in any other, any other formats. Like a player just taking out the whole team alone. I think the maximum number of players that I have seen before in those tournaments was like 3 players, 4 players, something like that.
Yeah, I mean, I just want to clarify something. I'm getting roasted by fellow old teammates from my Wasteland saying, I heard what you said. I just got to say, like, it wasn't your fault, bro, that our team didn't do well. It was definitely my fault.
But,
nah, I mean, I don't know. If you want to come on to our team, I'm sure you can carry us to some sort of victory.
Lucky seven. If you
wanna... Yeah, lucky seven, easy. Or Stano, if you want to be there in the reserved, I'm sure.
Reserved? I'm not coming.
Give us waters and stuff, you know?
Wow, okay.
I'm joking. But
I remember being the coach.
Yeah, you were the coach at one stage. We actually had that role. That was actually... Wait, was you, LeBron, and who else? I think it was just you and LeBron, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was pretty fun, but... We had some pretty good strategy going, but didn't work out in the official match. But all in all, it was a good experience and it was a fun time with some friends.
It definitely was. I mean, it was actually quite fun, like said previously, learning how to play. And obviously, had you guys to back us up. Obviously, we didn't do too well. But I mean, we've seen a lot of new teams within this format as well play. Like definitely in the, what is it, Challenger stages, that was quite interesting. Obviously, we didn't watch all the new teams play as such because obviously they wouldn't be as interesting because a lot of them kind of gave up midway within the Challenger stage. It was quite a rocky situation. But once we progressed into the Legend stages, we saw newer teams kind of develop and kind of show that they're not all what people say they are to be, you know. Don't judge a book by its cover. But yeah.
By the way, sorry for cutting you. I think we're gonna be starting soon. Yes, I see that both of the teams are joining right now. Three from Pointers and two from Knockout right now in the map. So yeah, I think that stuff are getting back to its place.
I don't know. I'm lagging. But yeah, I'm lagging right now, so I don't know, but
okay, I just lagged as well.
Yeah, I'm not too sure what will be happening here, but yeah,
I think if we start back, we're just gonna be starting the third round this round in 1-0 for the favor of Team Pointers.
Yeah.
But we need to get into the game first. That's the thing. So, meanwhile, everyone, let's get back to the questions. You guys can ask whatever you want, and we'll try our best to answer the questions that we can answer.
Indeed. But yeah, going back to what we talked about earlier about this champion stage and prediction wise, I want to go over the legend stage a little bit. I believe we talked a little bit about it to you, Steno, in the news show on what were your thoughts within the legend stages, and we've asked multiple people, but whilst we're on the stream, maybe newcomers didn't watch that, and also we can talk about it amongst ourselves. What did you think about this whole legend stage and the way it planned out? Do you feel like some teams were kind of like not saying they weren't deserved to be there, but you thought they wouldn't be placed within the champion stage, or do you think otherwise?
I feel like the legend stage, most of the teams that have made it through I feel like we knew and we kind of saw it coming. Some of the teams you could see that have gone through is because of the bracket that they've gotten. But I wouldn't say that it was an easy run for them. I think you're talking about ATB when you say that. But yeah, they have beaten some pretty good teams. Like they beat Fichki. They also beat their, I say, arch nemesis VTB. I say VTB is not a pretty bad team.
Yeah, what is this about ATB and VTB? Surely there's
some rivalry going on.
Is it actually a rivalry or is it like more like a friendly thing?
Oh, I'm not sure.
I don't know. I feel like it's a load of friends who couldn't join in the same clan, so they made two separate ones.
I have seen one of the players from ATB in the in-game clan of ATB playing VTB clan. Yeah, I have seen that. So maybe, I don't know, maybe it might be friendly.
Interesting. But yeah, I got to agree. I feel like maybe ATB had a couple easier games on their behalf. But like I said, they did beat Fichki, which I also thought was quite an interesting game. I didn't think they'd be able to beat that. But yeah, anyways, apart from that, I do feel like maybe DeathSight Horizon Gold Edition and Team Sincerity were all kind of gonna be knocked out, like prediction wise beforehand. But yeah, otherwise I think what the teams are now were pretty much I knew they would be there.
I feel like Horizon, they had a like pretty solid team. They had some experience as well, making it pretty far in the past tournaments. I feel like they easily could have done better. I know Toxic were beat them like 3-0 in their very first round, but they didn't have too bad of a bracket.
No, they went up against, wait, what was it? Toxic
and then knockout.
Yeah. I don't know who their third game was. Wait, let me see.
Gold Edition.
Oh yeah. Oh, that's the one they forfeited.
Yeah,
I remember that. Yeah, I feel like Horizon, once they lost Sneaky and LeBron, and once they lost that a game against Toxic, they're kind of like, guys, maybe it's a long day for us. You know, like it's gonna be hard going up against Knockout. But you're right, they definitely had the experience behind them. Like a lot of these players have quite a bit of experience. Like you got players like their leader Ed, Shrek, Loser and Spy. They've all played multiple games within the past, you know, old formats and whatnot. So yeah, I don't know, I feel like it was just them calling it a day off, you know.
And they also picked up Blame as well, who won first place in one of the minor tournaments. So I feel like they definitely had a pretty rounded team to at least crack top 8 in the legend stage, but that did not happen.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Sorry to cut you. I think we reset it and we're starting again, but it seems like just after the reset, the server gone mad again, I think.
Yeah, it gone brrrm, but
it is still going mad.
Yeah, it's going mad. It's unfortunate.
I was actually gonna say like, okay, let's start now and it's gonna be all good now, but I think, you know, like it seems like they're lagging again.
Sunday as well, come on man.
Yeah,
but yeah, this is unfortunate. Not too sure what will be happening here actually now, but we'll have to wait and see.
I think we have been in this for the past 15 minutes, but I don't know.
Longer,
maybe.
But yeah, anyways, these next games we got, so what we got tomorrow. Let's see what we got. We got obviously Red Notice and Dreamers. We talked about them a little bit. Obviously, Denno, you're on the side of Red Notice possibly passing through that elimination. And Sam, you said the Dreamers. You want to kind of talk about how far you feel like that game's going to go? Obviously, we don't know the maps they're going to be playing yet. We don't know anything about that game as of yet. Do you want to guess what's going to be happening, how many rounds they're going to be playing and whatnot, and why you think the Dreamers is possibly a better option to pass through that elimination stage or something?
Well, for the number of... I just want to note something first, because most of the people don't know it, is that the final and the battle for the third place is going to be 10 rounds, best of 10. And right now we're playing best of 6 until the semifinals. So basically, for me, you said I choose Dreamers. Yes, I choose Dreamers. I think that Dreamers have a really good potential, to be honest. Like Red Notice did really good as well. But I actually mixed up. It's my bad. Red Notice is the team that I mixed up between Red Notice and Black Mirror.
And you're like, oh no, I'm gonna lose this bet.
I'm sorry. Okay, I actually, it's what I'm saying. Basically, I thought that Red Notice are actually Black Mirror and the opposite. So I would say that Red Notice might go and win this one. I don't know. I had something to say if it was actually Black Mirror, but for Red Notice, it's gonna be, I would go for Red Notice, to be honest, not Dreamers.
Go ahead and say what you thought about Black Mirror, because I think if it was Black Mirror against Dreamers, I think Black Mirror would win that game. So I want to kind of hear what you were going to say about that.
Well, for Black Mirror, I think that I'm really scared that they might not have enough players. Like what happened with the Despite, that's the only thing. Because I hear that they had some issues with players, like maybe some of them have been traveling or something. That's why the last time they didn't have enough players. So that's the thing that I was scared to happen, and that Black Mirror wouldn't be able to actually play the match again, or something would happen this match. Even though I'm not, that was my reason basically, but still, that team was good because they managed to actually pull it off and win against Despite in the Legend stage and go to the Champion stage with only 4 players, and that was impressive. I'm not gonna lie. I had nothing against the players or the playstyle. It was basically just the attendance. I thought that it might be a problem for them to not have a player or two, because last time they had only 4 players, and even if this, I don't know if they could win a 5v4, but I would really, really want to point out that Despite were having a real sportsmanship and just played as 4v4. So basically, that's my reason to pick Red Notice, not Black Mirror. And that's why all the complications went like I actually said it's Black Mirror and I thought it was Red Notice. So I would say actually it's gonna be Team Pointers and Red Notice. And after that, I don't know what's gonna happen. Yeah, I don't know what's gonna happen. Like I was predicting that Black Mirror Team Red Notice. So I would want to know what's gonna happen between either Pointers or Knockout. Or Knockout and Red Notice, basically.
I mean, going back to Team Pointers and Red Notice, Red Notice won against Team Pointers, I think it was in the major rankings. No, Team Pointers didn't play in the major rankings 1, so it was major rankings 2. They won against them in that major ranking. So I do feel like possibly Red Notice will proceed from that. But going back to Black Mirror, obviously, they won against Despite. 3-1, and it was 4-5, but I don't know. I feel like Black Mirror has the potential to win against the Dreamers. We've never actually seen them play against each other officially on a stream, or they've not played within this format. So I'm not too sure. But what about you, Stan? What do you think about Black Mirror against the Dreamers?
I think that match has gone down before.
Has it?
If I'm not mistaken.
Check for me. Because I tried looking for it, but I didn't find it.
Yeah, you're right. Okay. I don't see it, but the Dreamers have been a pretty good team. We've seen them start up in TA format, so they've always had some pretty good experience with this type of format. They work pretty well. They're pretty experienced, but I feel like Black Mirror would be able to overcome the Dreamers.
Yeah, I would. Okay, I would go with you, Steno. Now, just recovering the what happened. So basically, yeah, I would do the same. But really, for real, like after I knew that, I'm really excited to see Pointers against Red Notice. Like, this is gonna be so intense.
Yeah. Isam, we got a question from the chat asking, why do you think Team Pointers are so dominant this entire tournament?
Well, for me, I think that they are dominant because the team itself consists of old esports players that has been playing the game for a long, long time. I remember Immortal since Starladder. He used to play Starladder a lot, and he used to play with the really old clans, and those old clans were really, really strong. Also, I remember Mr. Vanka from the days. He was also a Starladder player. So it was actually based on their experience and based on how much they played together. I think that's why they're dominant.
Go ahead.
All right. I just want to contradict what you're saying, is because you could say that, but we've seen teams like Black Mirror. Obviously, they're a newer team. Obviously, they've not got as much background history together as Team Pointers, but they passed into this champion stage. So even though they're not as dominant as you can see from Team Pointers, they have won some top tier games. So I don't know if that's the case in general. But what about you, Steno?
Honestly, I feel like with this new format, even though we have experienced players, it kind of hit a reset on the esports scene. And a lot of teams were struggling, kind of finding out what works, what doesn't. And I feel like what Team Pointers did well to help them in this tournament was finding out new tactics, new strategies, training with that. As we saw, as they came into the tournament, they changed the meta for the game. So I feel like they know how to adjust. They've been inventing the new tactics. They're pretty smart, and obviously they work pretty well together.
I would agree about that as well.
The server's lagging again, I think.
Yeah, I think this is gonna take some time.
We're trying to figure out what will happen with this game. Anyways, I believe Sam will have to go. So see you later, bro. And we'll let you know what happens in the end. But have a good one. Going on to this game. It's looking like it's lagging once again. I'm not too sure why that is. Obviously, we've had some DDoS attacks in the upcoming weeks, but passing weeks, excuse me, but I'm not too sure.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate. You hate to see that happening, especially in games like these when we're in the champion stage, where you see the intensity go up and then you see a stalemate.
We shall see. Honestly, This is crushing a lot of people's time. So obviously, people have been training for this moment, and then it gets sabotaged as such. But we shall see. We shall see. What do you feel like would happen? Do you think possibly we might see it being played tomorrow?
Yeah, that would, because we have the schedule as of now. I think each game is right after the other, so it would have to push the rest of the games later. I think right now they're going to try if they can get it back. It is the only game we are streaming today, but if it doesn't work out, I feel like they might just have to reschedule the game.
Yeah. We'll see. Anyways, how's your day been apart from this?
That took you a while to come up with.
I've been trying to think of things we could talk about, but yeah, gone through so much. But yeah, how's your day?
Yeah, it's been fine. Obviously, pretty excited about this tournament champion stage starting up. We have a lot of good games coming up soon, and I love the bracket. Like, we haven't seen a bracket like this.
I was just about to ask you about that.
Getting pushed out soon, single eliminations. I was going to make a prediction for the whole bracket, but we kind of did that already in the beginning. Yep. But it's pretty cool. Challenger stage, legend stage, and now finally we're at the champion stage. I think it's been a month since this tournament has started, so it's been a while.
No, there was that postponed, remember, from the challenger to the legend stage. I think it was a month wait, wasn't it?
Yeah, you're probably right.
And then we went into the challenger. So it's, I feel like it's only felt like a month because it's been like passing by so quick. Anyway, so same person's asking, what do you think needs to happen for Team P to be able to beat Team P? Oh, what do you think needs to happen for teams to be able to beat Team Pointers? Sorry. I'm so dried up right now. Do you want to go first or shall I?
Yeah, let me just pull up the bracket. I feel like Team Pointers, they aren't undefeatable. They've been playing well. I feel like once we get to further rounds of the stage, we'll see more competitiveness between the teams, mm-hmm. especially against Team Pointers. They'll be put up against some heavy hitters. For Team Pointers, so far what I've seen from them is they push together, they push and they surround the map. They don't just push one lane, and they always take advantage when the enemy team is on respawn to try and take control of their map and keeping them on respawn, taking the flag out. But I think any team that positions themselves well, controls their overdrives, works together, they all have a chance to beat Team Pointers. I've seen a lot of teams that are the underdogs that they play well, and they're able to beat like even stronger teams. I feel like this format allows you to do that, especially in the earlier stages. The skill gap wasn't too crazy, and I think that is one of the things about this format where anyone can win. Like, you could say that anyone can win, yeah. As long as you work together, use your overdrives, you have a chance of winning it.
Yeah, for sure. I would agree with you on that. Like, literally, if you just play your cards right, you don't get too heated in the moment, and you just stay along with your team and work together. It honestly, I feel like it's as much teamwork as it is like singly. Like, obviously in previous games, like in light format, you could do so much if you're solo playing. It was a lot easier to do stuff by yourself. But if you're playing like a team of four against five, like we saw against Black Mirror, Black Mirror against Despite, they had a hard difficulty playing the first round as 4v5. And then the spike gave them the benefit of the doubt to play against 4v4. And you saw the outcome. Like, you just work together as a team. You get those overdrives. You push the map like Team Pointers does. Like you were saying, Steno, like they control. Once they have that flag, they grip onto it like a dog would with his toy, you know? So, I don't know. It is, obviously, I wouldn't win against Team Pointers or any team, to be exact. But,
go on, just tell yourself.
but I'm sure your team could if you're playing. And yeah. Now I've got to underestimate myself. So then when actually I do play, I just swim, you know.
Oh, yeah.
I'm the underdog.
But yeah. I feel like this format has brought in a lot of new teams and players we haven't seen before. I feel like in light format, as you said, people with the best aim and the best strategies who would like stack up their teams, they kind of dominated for the past few tournaments. We would see the same players and almost the same teams. But I feel like now we've seen some new teams, some new players make it to the further stages. And I know some of the teams gotten into this tournament just because of them playing the minor tournaments, building up their RMR, and able to qualify for Gladiator straight off the rip.
Yeah. Talking about actually RMR, do you want to bring that up? We haven't discussed that in a while. I think LeBron was the last person to really talk about RMR because at the time, I think it was me and LeBron doing a live stream, and it was in the beginning of the challenger stages. And honestly, barely anyone really understood what RMR was, right? So do you want to tell everyone who's watching what RMR does towards your team and whatnot?
Yeah, to my knowledge, RMR points are just points you rack up so that at the end of the season, you can get seeded to qualify for the tournament. So as you win games and win tournaments, you get a specific RMR. Obviously, the higher you go, the more RMR points you get. So I think there was 3 minor tournaments to gain points before getting into the stage, and teams who built up that RMR just got a free invite to this tournament. I think only... the teams with 800 or more or 500 or more were able to get into this tournament. But I feel like next season, now that a lot of players have seen the prizes that were given out for this tournament, yeah. Might have came out as a surprise, they're going to be playing more seriously from the beginning, getting their points up. So we might see a more competitive major for, you think it's going to be for the winter major?
Honestly, I have no idea. With Tanky, you can't expect the unexpectable, right? But I hope so, because I wish there is a winter major and it comes closer. Because to be honest, this has been pretty fun watching the teams progress. Like you said, a lot of teams have been training and getting better. Newer teams and older teams. But honestly, I don't know. With the RMR, discussing a bit more about that, I believe some teams haven't even like destroyed their RMR. Like Team Diamonds, I think they've got the maxed out RMR because they haven't moved their players about. Yeah, Team Diamonds have the max amount of RMR, so they got 1,800, excuse me. But I'm losing my vision now. But obviously moving your players about, kicking players, transfers, that all affects your RMR. So I feel like they're keeping it on the safe side to hold it up. But yeah, I really don't know to answer your question, honestly. Anyways. They always ask who's Jack, but I want to know how are you, Jack. I'm doing good. I'm kind of in the mood about these issues right now, but I'm sure you guys are as well. But hopefully they will get knocked out of the way and we can finally see a game being played here. I think this is the third round, right, still?
Yeah, this will be the third round, and again, team pointers will have a one flag advantage as they scored that one flag in the previous round. But I think Knockout will have the full 10 minutes to kind of get that flag back and maybe capture another flag. I've seen a question about how Knockout can turn this around. This is where Knockout needs to come out and put up their fight. They got the pick for Sandal. They need to show us what they can do, take control of the map. And I think we see some more lag. I don't know if this round will be carried out.
Oh, wow. Yeah, it's hot and it's getting frustrating now. But let's see, let's see. I really hope there's a fix to this, and it's a Sunday. So I'm not too sure what the play is going to be here. I think we got a question. Do you want to read that one out? Because I kind of butchered the last one.
I already answered that one.
Did
He's
you
just the one
actually?
where
Oh
he's
yeah, you
asking
did a
what
while
Naka
ago.
should do. Yeah.
But yeah, what are the bets for the channel points? The channel points. That's a thing. Wait, you can bet? What am I? Channel points. I don't even know what this is. I didn't realize that was a thing
I have no
on
idea.
Twitch. Yeah. I'm quite new to Twitch, so I don't really know what this is. Lanky, who's talking in the call? That would be me, Jack, and also Steno. If you look on the like a little green box, and that's who's talking. But yeah. Let's see. Servers crashed again. Yeah. Anyways, let's see what happens here. Third round was obviously, I think, what was the timer before it happened? I think it was 7 minutes.
Yeah, around there.
Yeah, 7 minutes into round three. And it was currently 1-0, 14 pointers. The current score is 2-0, 14 pointers as well. They won both rounds on Sandbox. Would you say it was an easy couple rounds for them?
Yeah, I would say so. I feel like they kind of just went in there, just grabbed some flags and
They were in
got
the
out.
mood. They were in the mood. Who was it, Sam? Sam's currently left the stream. Fortunately, yeah, to dip. But yeah, I was really looking forward to this as well. But
Yeah,
anyways,
I see someone asking, what team do we want to see later in the stages? And I feel like right now a team that I or a match I want to see is Black Mirror against Diamonds. And I know Diamonds are probably the favorites for that matchup. And Black Mirror, they look like they kind of have a rough bracket. They have Diamonds to deal with, and even if they go through, they got Toxic. But if Black Mirror can come out and be the underdogs and take over, just beat Diamonds, and even if they go against Toxic, they have a chance to fight for that third place, which would be really fun to see.
Yeah, for sure. I'm actually rooting for Black Mirror, even though their paint is a bit iffy. I wouldn't
Yeah,
wear it. I'm
their
sorry,
paint
guys.
sucks.
I gotta vouch. Like that game would be interesting against Toxic as well. I think
A
we
little
know that
revenge game.
ATB. Yeah, a little. Yeah, exactly. But yeah, I feel like that would be interesting. But I don't know if Diamonds are gonna go easy on them. You know, gotta
Oh,
shadow
yeah,
that mirror.
for
But
sure.
anyway. Anyways, guys, we got some good but bad news. The good and bad news at the same time is the match will be rescheduled for tomorrow at 21 MSK. So it would be 7 GMT plus one, I believe.
Quick maths.
But yeah, Yeah, exactly.
Oh yeah.
It's not
You've
like
been here a while, huh?
Nah. Yeah, I've been there too long. When the time zone changes, then that's when I lose it, because obviously in the summer it gets plus one. But anyways, apart from the chit chat, that's gonna be it, guys. And thank you, Steno, and everyone else being here.
Yeah, for sure. We had a good game going. Unfortunate that we weren't able to see the end. But we'll be coming back tomorrow, starting off in Sandal. We'll see what Knockout can do, if they could bring this back, or if Team Pointers will just continue to dominate them and just walk through them for this first round.
Yeah, exactly. I'm looking forward to it as well. But yeah, anyways, with that being said, we'll see you later, Alligator, and skedaddle, skadoodle. Peace. Oh.